eyesight isn't too great. They can see pretty well from 4 to 5 meters, but their main senses are their hearing and their smell. By sticking her truck in her ear, this is comforting. This is trying to tell her to calm down and say it's all right. The girl's really upset at the moment. I'm not really sure why. Probably not honest. Again, she flips out about little things, but she's making a lot of the signs that she's just getting really agitated, stamping her feet on the ground, the trunk slaps, hitting her trunk on the ground like that. And obviously, the trumpet is a big sign that she's. Doing her job as the matriarch, the mother, sticking by her side, sticking that trunk on her face and her ears, very sensitive areas, and that's again this comforting social bond and trying to calm her down.
So after their bath and they've been washed of all the dirt, they go and put it back on. It acts as like their sun cream or moisturiser. So they take the old off and put a new on.
Found that one a little bit closer to him. Pump them full of sugar so they can have this energy to go out and work for the day. Work 10, 12 hours, not really getting time to rest or getting time to eat. And then for the night, they go back to the pen and maybe they have like a bale of hay for the night, but that's just not consistent enough for them. As well, a lot of times they keep them purposefully hungry, and that makes them, you know, weaker and easier to work and easier to handle this way. And from a combination of this extremely poor diet and also stress from being worked, Ji Miao actually develops an eating disorder. It's really fascinating how elephants can develop a lot of the same mental disorders that we can. It's one of the downsides of being pretty intelligent.
So what does that mean? So what's her eating disorder like?
Basically, with Ji Miao, the main thing she would do would be pretend to eat. She would go through periods where she'd eat a lot and get nice and big, especially after we rescued her, we'd think she was coming out of it. And then next couple weeks, we need to drop all this weight and, you know, pick up grass and things and either put it through her mouth and spit it out or just bring it up and kind of just toss it to the side.
Yes. Oh my god, look at my bags. Oh, that's not good. It's day 2 of the Elephant Valley project and I've just woke up and this is my view from where my room is. Completely in the wild. So I'm just in these huts and that's my room.
While Sambo at the moment still needs, because we do counts every now and then, she still uses about 11 trunks wiped. We're not even half the amount of grass she's actually putting in them out compared to her. So we're hoping by having them together in the afternoon, Sambo seeing Malot eating and how she's eating, that Sambo will learn to be a bit more efficient in collecting grass.
Yeah.
Even though she's not as round.
Yes, let's that one go back.
All right, then.
See you later.
I'll see you guys later.
Thank you. Yeah. It is day 3 and it's Christmas Day. Merry Christmas!
Whatever you do.
Alright then guys, before we all go to this side of the waterfall here, nearly all of it, it could only be second.
So Laura's given me another letter to be opened when it's Christmas, and this is what's in it. Lots of chocolate and balloons.
Yes. Right, for yours.
Tyler and Leonie times two.
Yeah.
Everybody, hold on to your wish.
Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. The Elephant Valley project has 8 elephants and they're split between 3 locations. So first I visited the Heaven Valley, which has 4 elephants in. Then second there was River Valley, which I visited in the afternoon of my first day, which has 2 elephants. And they're best friends, but they don't get on with any of the other elephants. They have to be put in their own valley to decrease the chance of bullying and stuff. It's really funny because they're like humans. They all have their little attitudes and their cliques and stuff like that. So it's really nice to see how they're all so different from one another. And you could obviously tell as well. I wasn't sure if, because I never watched elephants before, whether that was going to be hard or not, but it was pretty easy. And then they have 2 other elephants, which are both isolated on their own, just kind of out of choice and for health reasons. So one was from Phnom Penh, which is the capital of Cambodia, and she worked there for 35 years, carrying tourists. And so 35 years on concrete, which meant her feet are absolutely ruined, so she has to have daily baths in iodine to fix them. So she's been there for quite a long time now, and they're getting better, but it's still like a few years before they are at the like back to normal. So she has to be kept close to camp so she can have these washes. And then the second elephant is was rescued on the brink of starvation, so they're just bringing her back to health and trying to get her weight up and things like that. There's only actually around 400 to 500 elephants remaining in Cambodia, and 150 of those are in captivity, so where they're still being worked or in sanctuaries such as where I was. And there's 2 reasons for this. It is number one, from the Vietnamese War, where a lot of the east of Cambodia was highly bombed, and so therefore killed lots of elephants. The second reason is the Khmer Rouge has a lot of anger, killed all the elephants as a sign of power. And then the other reason within the Khmer Rouge
is a lot of families pet their elephants, just to stop them from starving.